Hello everyone and welcome to some Heroes of the Storm. Now we're going to be taking a look at a game that we did a long time ago. Let me just find out which number I am. I'm number 7 I think, and hopefully we can do the smart pan. And in today's game we are playing, it is a Hero League game. It has been taken, it was recorded a while ago, or should I say it was played a while ago. It is currently being recorded right goddamn now. And we are playing some ETC. Now, I thought this would be a good game to show off because I think I played a bit better as ETC than in the placement games. I needed a chance to redeem myself, and I think this game might just do that. Now, I can't actually remember the outcome of the game. All I titled the replay as is good ETC. So, if we win, I'm not really bothered, but apparently this is some good ETC. So, they do have the Sylvanas comp, which means they're going to tower rush. But we're going to follow it up, we're going to follow some up, and hopefully get some kills. We managed to single out the Rhaegar. Do we have enough damage? Yes, we do. That was a 4v5. They did take some tower hits, but that was a 4v5. As you can see, Vala did not leave top lane. And I can move my mouse out the way, because we're never going to use that mouse. We can look at the talents with N. At level 1 we took Rolling Like a Stone. Increases the range of our power slide, so we can engage and disengage from a greater distance. I'm not sure who wins versus ETC and Sonya. I would assume it would be Sonya, but I can heal and she can slightly heal. Getting a little bit aggressive here, but Brightwing does come in. It's sometimes hard to let your team know that you're just showing face to the enemy team and pretending as if you're going to engage. That makes them back off, but that obviously doesn't really translate well to your team, and sometimes your team can go in because of that, and you can get your team killed as the warrior by just pretending to square up to the enemy team, even though you had no intention of actually engaging. So do be aware of that. I have killed teammates doing that before. Now we should be able to bully Falstad a little bit. We can heal up, but we can engage with the power slide and do some damage. As long as we dodge his Q and stop letting him stack up on us, that's the main goal right now. We see Vala swinging round here. We then stun him. That might give us enough time. And it does. It does. All because he decided to turn around and shoot an ability. If he decided not to turn around at all and just leave, then he might have survived there. But he got a little bit greedy, tried to do some damage to Vala and died because of it. So they're going to send up a Sonya to rotate and collect the XP. Pretty good. Pretty good from the other team. I am so overextended. Do I die? I can't remember. Actually, Vala's been ignored. She got a lot of damage off there. Alright, tribute is... it's first tribute. First tribute is spawning in the bottom lane. Brightwing's coming down with me. Yeah, she did just teleport, so she's not going to have a teleport ready, which is why she's going to have to flap all the way down. We might just have to give this one up. Vala, yeah, I think we've gave this one up. Vala's very slow. And Nazebo trying to stall, but he didn't, so that's okay. I mean, it's the first tribute, makes no, it's no big of a deal. Not big of a deal. As long as we can outsoak them, then we are in a good shape. Do I need to save Thrall here? He should be able to get away. Yeah, okay. So, I didn't actually change my character. I made him go down the bottom lane while I made sure with my camera that I was checking on Thrall, making sure he was okay. We're just waiting in the gank bush for a gank. ETC is perfectly fine for doing ganks in the bushes. You don't have to have your DPS in bushes for a gank. You can have, especially ETC, you can have him or Muradin in the bush as a ganker. We see a good opportunity to go for Sylvanas and we block her from getting in the gate. Ripperino. The polymorph as well, there was a perfectly timed polymorph as well. It stopped Sylvanas being able to use her Windrunner. Had she got that off, she would have escaped. But the combination of the polymorph plus the body blocks was enough to, just delete her from the game. Now, I am in position, but I don't see any of the enemy team trying to cap it. We do now, but we still have very, very slow DPS in this match. Very slow DPS. I'm attacking Johanna. I shouldn't be. Power slide in to get the kill on Falstad. Attack Johanna again. Why don't I? Sonya moving into the back line, so I'm going to zone out the rest of the team. We might actually get Johanna here. Well played. Well played. Now, what did I go for at level 4? I'm just zoning out Sylvanas there for the team. We went for Guitar Hero at level 4. Level 7. Sometimes you can go for follow through, sometimes you can go for loudspeakers. But I went for basic attacks heal while we are using guitar solo. It's just a little bit of extra healing because Brightwing is heal over time. They don't have that gigantic heal like a Rhaegar or a Uther or somebody like that. So any little bit of extra healing we can get is great. ETC doesn't have any damage reduction. Wow, what a good power slide. Secures yet another kill. So ETC doesn't have damage reduction on the jump like Muradin does. He doesn't really have block or anything like that. Does he have block? He might actually have block, but it's not. Yeah, he does have block, but it's a lot worse than getting rolling like a stone in the majority of cases, I would have said. Level 4, we got double neck guitar, increases the width and the power slide faster. Sometimes people can go. What do people sometimes go? I don't know. I think double neck guitar is a pretty good one. Sometimes people go for hammer on. I think it's hammer on. But I like what we've gone so far. And level 10, you can probably already guess we're gonna go for the mosh pit. Wow, Vala is so overextended. I'm way too far back. Basically, me and Vala need to switch. She's in the back lines. And I'm in the back lines and she's in the front lines. But it's okay. Power slide securing another kill on the Sonya. We did lose Vala there, but we're okay. We might actually pick up. Can we pick up a... No. Oh, that last second heal from Rhaegar. So we're just going to play our guitar. And head on out of there. Got ourselves level 10 and a tribute. Very nice. So we're going to tap the well, head down to Sylvanas, see if we can catch her out of position. And if not, at least soak the XP. She's still in bomb lane. She's still pushed up. I can't kill her on my own, though. Can't kill her on my own. So we are left to just soak. Could have been a kill, but it seems... Well, Nazebo is way pushed mid, and we have Vala in the bush doing... She ran to top lane and then ran all the way back to mid lane without doing anything. I see Sylvanas in the bush. I know she's there. Can't really do anything about it. So I'm more concerned with just clearing the wave and then getting the hell out of there. But we're going to leave a little gank bush on the way there. Unfortunately, you can't see that because we're... Oh, never mind. Sylvanas has moved. Reign of Vengeance does miss. That's a 3v2. The team is engaging. This is bad. Luckily, Thrall and Brightwing both have escapes. And we managed to segregate the Rhaegar yet again. And I think that Rhaegar has been a little bit too aggressive in his placements. ETC is quite a good counter to Rhaegar because Muradin, I mean, if a target is moving 30% faster, then it's harder to land a skill shot. But the power slide is, it's really difficult to miss a power slide. And it also stuns and it gets you in position for a... What's it called? Face melt. Yep, face melt. I just think ETC is a much more effective tank at getting to Rhaegar than a lot of other tanks. And we drop the mosh pit to secure ourselves 2 kills. Well, 1.5 kills. God damn it. That should have been 2 kills. We didn't quite have the damage there. Vala is exceptionally starved on mana. Well, that's okay. That's okay. We got 1 kill. It helps us push up the bot lane and the top lane. And at level 13, we got Showstopper, so we take 25% less damage every time we power slide. And that is when you are your most vulnerable, when you power slide into danger. So to get a little bit... Oh, Vala, you are so dead. You are so dead. I would try and save you, but I think you are still so dead. Yes, if you had dodged that Q, you might have been allowed to live. A whiffed leap. Totally whiffed leap. I'm actually going to get out just because of the leap. Or do I? No! Brightwing, save me! Oh man, I forgot all of this happened. Even Brightwing gets out. Do we get a counter kill? Oh, I so want the counter kill. But it's 4v3. Holy balls. I can't believe we got out of there. And we also got out of there, even, and Brightwing got out of there as well, even though she ported into four people. Alright, so reset, relax, and revert to doing camps. We are 3 fourths ahead. We are 2 levels ahead. And we're 1 tribute behind, but we have had a curse. So I think all in all, we're in a pretty good position. Strangely enough, nobody has gone for any bosses yet, although that's where they could be right about now. It looks like they're at the boss. Do we realize? Nope. I think Varla's just going to die. Man, Varla's are so squishy. I haven't played Varla in months. Absolutely months. She's just way too squishy for my liking. I like people with health or mobility. Or health and mobility. Are they still trying to do boss? We can muscle in here. We're 2 levels ahead, 4v4, we can muscle in. And I think Falstad is pretty weak in health. Okay, they've backed off. Oh, come on, this has to be a kill on the Rhaegar. No, I power slid in the wrong direction, but we baited out the Blessed Shield. Which is a 60 second cooldown, I want to say. At level 16, what did we take? Oh, we missed the Sonya. At level 16, we took Imposing Presence, mainly because they have Sylvanas, Rhaegar, Falstad, and Sonya. So Sonya does some good auto-attack damage. She also has that W damage. Falstad also has pretty good mage damage, but also has quite good auto-attacks. So it's worth taking it. What else does he have at level 16? I mean, we could have gone for Speed Metal or Echo Pedal, both very good options, but I think I just went for the safer play of reducing damage to myself. But we can get these guys. We can totally get these guys. Varla went in a little bit too quickly. You've got to wait for your tank. Never mind. We've got way too much damage for these guys now. Rhaegar, a little bit too quick. Can we cut him off? Mayhem. If I can get out of the goddamn minion wave, we might be able to mount up and cut him off. We should enlist the aid of these. Where did he go? It doesn't matter. Oh no, the mosh pit gets interrupted by the condemn, but it was just enough to stop Sylvanas using her Windrunner yet again. It's not called Windrunner, is it? It's called Haunting Wave. It should be called Windrunner, just because it's a lot easier to say. So they have a Sonya split pushing top for a single fort. Not much else they can do with Sylvanas dead, actually. That Sylvanas kill really swung the fight for us. Swung the game even more into our favour. It let us get the boss, which will push down the bottom keep. Now, I'm in favour of going to get the tribute. The rest of the team wants to go and kill the keep. However, the keep will die on its own from the boss, so... we're a little bit split right now. I wanted to get the tribute and the boss. They want to push down the keep. So this is not good. We have one person mid, one person top, and 3 people pushing down bottom lane. I think I remember this bit. I think this is the only bit of this match I remember. Now I realize that sucking XP, probably not a good idea. I was waiting for the friendly team to retreat, but they weren't, so I was like, well, I guess I better join them. We'll get the keep, eventually. And we're going to try and segregate Johanna, but I mean, Johanna's Johanna. The Gust gets cancelled by the Condemn. The Wailing Arrow comes in. The Blessed Shield was used. We have 20 seconds on Mosh Pit. Can I get my team out of here? Yes, but Thrall decides to jump back in for whatever reason. That was pretty bad. We get a 3-man stun. Is that enough to segregate Johanna? Yes, it is. The Ravenous Spirit. I think that's the first time we've seen it that game. Ravenous Spirit comes in. Doesn't seem to do an awful lot, gonna be honest. We now have Mosh Pit up. That would have been a... Yeah, that was a good time for Mosh Pit. A little bit late, I would have said, but it does secure us a kill. Not the one we had Mosh Pitted, but it's going to secure us a kill nonetheless. Now, at this point, it's damage control. We need to get out there without anybody dying. And holy crap, we managed it. I don't think Vala was there at all, was she? I don't know, I was too busy looking at the fight, but... I don't think... Oh, I remember this bit. This bit is pretty good. Hey, Falstad! Welcome! This is my team, Zalan, now. And just like that, we get a double kill. Just like that, we get a double kill. So if we did get that tribute earlier, instead of pushing greedily with the bottom keep, we could have had a curse now, just so you know. Which I think, in the long run, would have been a better idea, because, well, we would have had a curse. We would have had a curse. So Thrall's asking, are we that good or are they that bad? I think it's a little bit of a mixture of both. But I'm just wanting to show everybody that I can ETC. I can, honestly. Sometimes that I can. He gets banned an awful lot in Hero League now. So you're pretty lucky to get him. He's normally the... Thrall, you're gonna die, buddy? Thrall! He's normally the second ban. Definitely second ban phase. Ghost Inc. Never mind, bro. Get stunned. I even drop a hashtag. Hashtag lol. That's probably the cringiest thing I've ever said in team chat. So when you're in a good position like this, two tributes with level 20 to level 17 and 20 people and 20 seconds on one of their team dead, what you want to do is grab the boss first. Thrall didn't listen, but what you want to do is grab the boss first and then grab the tribute and save yourself some time. This effectively wasted us about 10 seconds of the curse to get the boss when you wait until the boss is at their keep, just about to use their first attack on the keep, and then you collect the tribute. That maximizes your curse time. I don't know what Sonya was doing there, but she, you know, she's just gonna die. That was silly. Excellent. So you want to grab, if you're in a position like that, you want to grab the curse right about now. Okay, so the boss has just reached the two towers at the top there. That's when you want to grab the curse. And we're just wrecking them now. So that was the optimal timing. So you can see we've only got 15 seconds left on the curse now because Thrall got it way too early. They were in no position to contest. I mean, at this point, it wouldn't have really mattered. But I'm just talking about, like, min-maxing here. That's when you want to grab it. So that was awfully one-sided. I'll have a look and see if we have any more... slightly more balanced games.